Small and big, the big and small, they congregate at a Svenska Hall. They drink a foaming brew, take on a rosy hue. The president pulls a string and they blow their foam and sing.
I think the pioneers of Vail, the people that went through the early years and made Vail possible, all had the kind of background living in the mountains, skiing, climbing, being a part of the 10th Mountain Division, had adopted a point of view that anything was possible, that when problems came along in the early years of Vail, instead of saying, oh God, we can't handle that, we just said, we'll do it, there's a way to do it, and went ahead and did it, and got it done. And that's why Vail got built, and that's why it turned out the way it did.
I was a barmaid in the mountain inn. 'Twas there I learned the wages, the misery of sin. Along came a skier, fresh from off the slope.
And he's the one that ruined me and shattered all my hopes. Singing 90 pounds of rucksack, a pound of grub or two.
Are you a skier? Are you a mountain climber? Do you enjoy the great outdoors and have a passion for nature? The U.S. Army needs your help in training skiers and climbers for a new division of tactical specialists. These skills are necessary in the landscape of today's global war. The Army wants to hear from you.
Jumped into the skier's bed to keep the skier warm.
On November 15th, 1941, just 3 weeks before the tragedy at Pearl Harbor, the 87th Infantry Mountain Regiment was activated, dubbed the 10th Mountain Division. These men made up the first mountain regiment in United States military history. On the outskirts of Leadville, Colorado, sat Camp Hale, the training center for the 10th Mountain Division. At an elevation of 10,000 feet above sea level, Camp Hale provided the rigorous training conditions needed to get the men of the 10th in shape to handle the terrain overseas.
We had A and B slopes down at Camp Hale. They were small slopes. We would pack up our rucksacks and hike from Camp Hale up to Cooper Hill and then bivouac out in the area, and they had a T-bar lift then. It's the same poles that are used now for the chairlift they have, and we did our training there.
So they had an exercise which was called the D series, which was a 6 weeks in the middle of winter simulated combat. We lost a number of people. We lost some to frostbite. We had ski accidents.
I came to the conclusion they were trying to kill us.
The 10th Mountain Division deployed for combat in Italy in January of 1945. Although missions were considered successful, heavy losses were suffered.
Without the soldiers of the 10th Mountain Division, the Colorado ski industry would look considerably different than the one we celebrate this evening. Trained at Camp Hale, just 20 minutes from here, 14,000 young men learned to ski, along with intense training in technical mountain climbing, winter survival skills, and of course, how to fight. They were the best of the best. In 1944, the 10th was deployed to Italy. Riva Ridge and Mount Belvedere, the cornerstone of the German defenses, had to be taken. Two previous attempts had failed, and the 10th was ordered to do the impossible, and they delivered. By taking Riva Ridge, the 10th had executed the most successful Alpine assault in U.S. military history. At the end of the war, when German General von Sanger was presented with surrender documents, he asked, as a point of honor, to be allowed to surrender to General George Hayes and the 10th Mountain Division. Von Sanger wrote in his war diaries, that the 10th Mountain Division was my most dangerous opponent.
The Army skier's best by far, he'll bring you under the bar. The roughest, the toughest, we're dirty and mean, hungry and lean, but our rifles are clean. We'll fight to the finish, we'll shoot any hill.
Following the conclusion of the war, the men of the 10th returned home, many to Colorado. They were instrumental in the development of skiing as a recreation industry and a major sport, helping to create the state's burgeoning ski industry with at least 60 ski resorts founded by the men of the division. Up to 2,000 men of the 10th were involved in ski-related professions following the war. Now headquartered in Fort Drum, New York, the division has been one of the most deployed units in the Army since 2001. Its combat brigades have seen over 20 deployments to both Iraq and Afghanistan in support of Operation Iraqi Freedom and Operation Enduring Freedom. In October of 2016, the 10th Mountain Division returned to Colorado as a result of a U.S. Army directive. Today, some of the 730 soldiers from the 1st Battalion of the 157th Infantry of the Colorado National Guard are aligned with the 10th Mountain Division. The repatching ceremony took place at Camp Hale, and the newest 10th troopers will conduct winter training at Camp Hale and in the surrounding mountains. We indeed owe the 10th Mountain Division a debt of gratitude for preserving our freedom and creating our industry.
We had pride in what we were, pride in what we accomplished.
The 10th Mountain Division played a unique and incomparable role in defeating the Axis powers during World War II. But their impact on the ski industry and anyone who has ever stepped in a pair of skis remains. The rigorous training was unlike any other experienced by United States military servicemen at the time. The men carried with them a courage and honor that has survived long past their duty. And their sacrifice is something that will be appreciated in the ski community forever.
In the mountains, in the woods, we take our chances with anyone.
It was different. Military skiing was entirely different than what I pictured it.
If you think of a mountaineer, you think of a character. You were with a group of people that had that tendency.
And there are some days, you know, it was so beautiful, so inviting. We just take off.
These guys were not only fun-loving, but man, they were tough.
We were there because we wanted to be there.
And I thought they were going to kill us all off.
Just keep your heads and remember your instructions.
We paid a very, very severe price for the number of months we were in battle against the Germans. 1,000 were killed and 4,000 more were wounded. The greatest blessing that came out of the 10th for many of us was the great common love of the mountains. And it became the lives of most of us.
These guys are not only war heroes, but to me, heroes in the ski industry.
We sort of are the fathers of the modern ski industry.
The band of brothers, we were part of that.
The 10th Mountain Division.
The 10th Mountain Division.
10th Mountain Division.
10th Mountain Division.